Some days things just take way too much of my energy. I look up and the whole room's spinning. You take my cares away. I can so overcomplicate. People tell me to medicate. Feel my blood running, swear the sky's falling. I don't know if this shit's fabricated.
Morning, Carlton. Today is Monday, April 6th. I'm Maggie Regal.
I'm Bailey Vetter, coming at you from Windows 95.
And I'm Evan Walker. Let's get into it.
Mrs. Gallagher is working remotely to make sure that all seniors can complete any college applications. Please send transcript requests to carrie.gallagher@carlinton.k12.pa.us. If you have any other questions regarding registering for next year's classes, how to begin college applications, or where to find scholarship information, reach out to your guidance counselors for more information. That is all I have. I will pass it over to the next one.
Don't forget that we have a brand new segment called Quarantine Art. We're looking for drawings, paintings, sketches, sidewalk talk, and more. Please send photos of your artwork to wchscarlinton@gmail.com and check back to see your artwork featured right here. And look what we have today. We have two submissions from 8th grader Abigail Tomajewski. Look at this first one on the canvas. Oh, that looks really nice. I like the way you ombre the sky because I've never been able to do anything like that. And we also have water and mountains in the background, which I don't think any of us have been in the water, near water, or on any mountains lately because, you know, coronation. And we also have this second one, which is an example of some sidewalk chalk art. We haven't had any of this yet. I'm excited to have some of it. It looks like we have some water and a beautiful sunset right here. You can't really see that much water right now, but I'm sure you can still see the sunset. Look through your window. I mean, I guess you can go outside while you go for your walks outside for social distancing, but stay by your window, please. And here we have two paintings by Junior Darius McClendon. And must I say, those flowers look nice because the best flower I can draw is this. I don't know if you can see that. I got some YouTuber clout right here with my focus, my hand behind the thingy. You know, they do that anyway. That's the best flower I can draw. I don't even know how you do them shadows. I don't know how you artists do the shadows because I've never been able to do shadows with things. But boy, does it look nice. And for our final submission, we have epoxy tumblers made by Carlinton senior Jenna Craig. For those who do not know, Jenna is an entrepreneur who started her own epoxy company, has been featured online at the Our Town Market and many other places. Jenna's first tumbler is made to look like a Lysol container, just in time to keeping things sterile and safe. Since she has tons of more designs, can even take custom orders too. The first one we have here is like a tie-dye design I think is pretty cool. The second one is if you want to connect to nature, you can get this wonderful, beautiful flower design. And the last one is if you like reading, because reading is lit. Get it? Reading lit. If you would like to order your Tumblr, reach out to Jenna, colorfulcraftcreations20@gmail.com, and get yours today. Thanks to everyone for sending in their art. Email us at wchscarlinton@gmail.com to submit your art. And as always, thanks for making us proud.
And now we'll go to today's special guest, Junior Natalie Lutziff, who will tell us what she's been up to.
Hey, Carlinton people. It's Natalie. I was forced to be the guest speaker. Evan forced me. I hope everyone's doing well, and I hope everyone is being safe. Something that I've been doing during my quarantine, I've been going on walks around Carnegie Park and runs, so if you see me, don't say anything. And yeah, I've just been running and walking and baking. Yeah.
Thanks, Natalie, and we're glad you're getting some fresh air. And now it's time for everybody's favorite local weatherman. Let's go to Jack for the weather.
I'm in a mobile weather center. Well, this week is supposed to be up and down. You can see highs in the upper 60s today and tomorrow. You can look for highs reaching 75 degrees. But a big cool down is supposed to come this week. And we'll push drop next week, and we'll push drop into the upper 40s, and lows might be in the upper 20s. And this week, you can look for thunderstorms. Thunderstorms may be severe with hail, heavy rainfall, lots of lightning, thunder, and gusty winds. A possible tornado is not out of the question. Please be prepared for these storms. And power outages and power lines might be a problem. I'm Carlton, and I'm Jackson reporting live in my mobile weather center. Back to you.
Thanks, Jack. We'll wrap up with the joke of the day. Today's joke of the day comes to us from Carlton's very own history teacher, Mr. Patsko. There are these two young fish swimming along, and they happen to meet an older fish swimming the other way, who nods at them and says, "Morning, boys, how's the water?" The two young fish swim on for a bit, and eventually one of them looks over at the other and goes, "What the heck is water?" Sometimes we don't even realize that we are already successful. Take a look around and notice your success today, Carlinton. Thanks for that reminder, Mr. Patsko. We miss you.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching.
And thank you for continuing to practice social distancing. See you back here on Wednesday, Carlinton.
Code Z, 1, 2, 1, 2.
These people start to fade. These people start to fade. These people start to fade.